Unconscious bias, systemic racism, racial prejudice. These are words we've heard a lot over the past few weeks. But what do they mean? The police minister has previously claimed that there is no systemic racism in the New Zealand police force, but there are signs of unconscious bias. There is also damning evidence unconscious bias affects employment, access to healthcare, and outcomes in criminal justice. But as the term itself suggests, are we unconsciously doing this without any bad intent? So joining us now to unpack this term and its ramifications is our resident psychologist, Jacqui Maguire. It is so good to see you this morning.
Kaylee, it's so nice to see you back on screen. Hello.
Hi. Let's talk about this unconscious bias versus systemic racism. What is unconscious bias and how does it differ from systemic racism?
Yeah, sure. So unconscious bias describes a phenomenon that we all have internalised belief systems or schemas that we're unaware of that influence our actions and our behaviours. And that can be based on race, it can be based on gender, it can be based on weight, religion. There's a whole raft of things we have unconscious bias on. But what we know is that people's behaviour that is therefore unintentional can still have very large ramifications on a group of people that normally are disadvantaged compared to another group. So whilst I might be unaware of how I'm acting based on these unconscious belief systems, it causes quite significant vindication to another group. For example, as we've seen in our police force or in overseas in America, we know, for example, that people hold unconscious bias on people of colour versus people that are Pākehā, which is seen, for example, that people have unconscious biases, that people of colour are more hostile than those that are Pākehā or white, which you can then see how if a whole police force or people in the police hold that internal view without knowing it, that can then interfere in how they respond to someone who might, for example, have an ambiguous object in their hand. Mm-hmm. If someone's of colour, they might interpret that is a weapon compared to somebody that's white and they might think, you know, that it's not. That differs from systemic racism. Systemic racism is almost the water we swim in. It's the fabric woven into our society. And it shows that racism is insidious and woven into every part of our life, through our laws, through our policies, through the way that we govern. It's not formed by chance, Hayley. Systemic racism is formed on historical injustice. There is a wonderful TED talk by a doctor called Kamara Jones who speaks on unconscious bias might be you and me walking around making decisions, not aware of what's going on inside our brains. But systemic racism is like the soil we're all growing in. So it doesn't matter how much potentially you challenge people's unconscious biases. If the system doesn't shift, then a group of people are going to continue to be disadvantaged, which will impact us all because we are then not harnessing and utilising all the amazing talent and resource we have in our people.
So do you believe Police Minister Stuart Nash then when he says there is no systemic racism in our police force, just possibly unconscious bias? Do you believe him when he says that?
When you look at the numbers, Hayley, and you go, Māori are 6 times more likely to be handcuffed, they're 11 times more likely to be pepper sprayed, they're 9 times more likely to have dogs set upon them, 2/3 of fatal shootings in the last decade have been Māori, I would find it hard to believe that's only unconscious bias. I would think that is a signal that absolutely there are systems in play that are supporting a disadvantage between Māori and the rest of us.
That is shocking, but I guess you have to acknowledge things in order to fix them. How can we fix this?
The unfortunate thing is when you look through the research, there is no evidence that any form of training is beneficial at the moment. And you will know in organisations that people go and they run diversity training and they implement trainings to help support people to understand their unconscious bias, etc. Unfortunately, some of that research shows that can be more damaging than useful. And we actually don't know, Hayley, what's helpful. I suppose when we look at this, yes, we can get people to look at their thought processes. We can get people to get uncomfortable and challenge some of their beliefs and their decisions that we're making. We can, as individuals, take responsibility for learning about our history here in New Zealand, and taking that upon ourselves rather than asking Māori to be responsible for us in terms of educating us. But really, this isn't going to change unless we as a society shift and refocus and work together to really change the water we're swimming in.
Very, very quickly, unconscious bias is ingrained in us from our childhood. How can parents ensure that the next generation don't carry this with them?
Yeah. We have to, as adults, get uncomfortable with what we're thinking, what we're acting, and we've got a role model to our children. We need to be able to call out racism when we see it, because even if unconscious bias is unintended behaviour, it's still racist and it's still causing an impact. So we need to be able to interrupt and show our children that we're interrupting racism when we see it. And I think we need to have very open conversations with our kids around what's happening in this country, what's happening in the world, about unconscious bias and how we need to all strive to do it better. Will it ever go away, unconscious bias, and Hayley? I don't know, but I damn well hope so.
So do I. Thank you so much, Jacqui Maguire, our resident psychologist.